Hi YouTube, in this video we will learn how to calculate a sum of two integer number in C++. So first I'm going to show you that how this program is going to work, and then we will start writing the code. So let's say that we have two numbers, let's say 10 and 5. We want to calculate its sum, which is 15. So if you add 10 plus 5 is equals to 15. So what we are going to do in C++, so let's say if you enter this 10, you want to enter this 10 value. For this, we will, let's say we take a variable a and stores this value in a, and for this second value we will be declaring another variable, which is b. Now let's say a has 10 value and b has 5. Now we want to calculate its sum. So let's say if we add a plus sign, it is going to add both of them, and the result is 15. Now one more thing, that we need another variable which stores this result in that particular value. So for that we can take sum is another variable that stores this result in it. So what we are going to do, that sum equals to a plus b. So there are also other methods, like you can also print the result in cout statement. So I'm going to show you guys how you can do that as well. So this is just a basic program I'm just creating for the beginners which do not know how to calculate the sum. So I hope the when I start writing the code, I just want you to make sure you watch every step so that you understand each and everything. Okay guys, let's start writing the program. Now we want two variables which takes our result, that 10 or plus 5 or any value. So let's say a and b, and that third variable which stores our result. Now we can write over here this program calculate sum of two integer so C out enter first number. So what happens, that if I enter 10 or any value, it stores in A. Now this result A and B, it is going to be stored in, because we need one variable which stores the result. For example, if you add two things, so there must be another thing to which store in that particular thing. So that's why we are using this variable, because we cannot store anywhere else. Because what we are going to do, if we write that A plus B, so okay, it is going to calculate like this. For example, if you say that A plus B, so what is this? It is nothing. So there must be something or some variable which stores its result. That's why I have used sum. So I just want that result should be stored somewhere. So that's why I have used another variable, which is sum. Now I'm going to write that on sum of A plus B is some. So now let's execute this program and see what happens. Okay, so our program start executing from this, that it just print this line that this program calculates sum of two integer. Now our program is over here that enter a first number, so I just say that I have entered 10. Now it says that enter second number, which I'm going to write 5. Now the sum of 10 plus 5 is 15. Now as you can see that you can also do some changes, like you can also do, for example, if I just say A plus B, now I'm going to get the result 15 as well. So it depend upon you that what logic you're going to use. So as you can see, the result is 15. So instead of using another variable, you can also perform this action like this, which I have just performed like this, that in C or statement you can also use A plus B. So there are lots of methods which you can use, and it depends upon your ability, that which it's depend upon your thinking. So I hope this video might work for you and you understand. So if you still face any problem, you can just comment it down below and I'll try to help you guys. So, and like this video, subscribe to this channel, and stay classy.